Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to a special Father's Day edition of SICW Wrestling Explosion. I'm Drew Abenhouse, and today we feature six-man tag team action as the team of the Iron Man Ken Casa, Heath Hatton, and your Canadian hero Sean Vincent go to war against superstar Steve Fender, Axe, and the 400-plus-pound monster Troll. Two bulls collide in the center of the ring as the big Texan locks horns with big country Clint Poe. And since it's our Father's Day episode, we journey back in time to take a look at one of the most prolific father-son combinations in St. Louis wrestling history, Johnny and Greg Valentine. Don't go anywhere, fans. Six-man tag team war begins right after a quick word from our sponsors.
Farm music and fun, the place to party is Pop's nightclub and concert venue in Sojay. From Bruno Mars or the first U.S. tour of Nickelback to Flogging Molly or the Insane Clown Posse, 30 years of memories pack Pop's concert venue with more made at every new show. And there's a party at Pop's nightclub every night, a melting pot of friends enjoy the best in dance, rock, pop, and top 40 music until 5:30 a.m. Plus add a full game room. Check out all the action at PopsRocks.com. Then and now, the place to party is Pop's in Sojay.
Belva Mechanical Incorporated is the place to go for commercial and industrial heating, ventilation, air conditioning, and refrigerating work. Their Union Sheet Metal Shop is the most modern, well-equipped in southwestern Illinois. Their work on the SIUE Engineering Building won Belva Mechanical the Madigan Special Merit Award for New Construction. Call 233-0081 for information. Belleville Mechanical will fabricate ductwork and custom fittings to your specifications. The highest union quality, superb workmanship, state-of-the-art equipment. Contact Belleville Mechanical.
And there you see Steve Fender, superstar, throwing Heath Hatton right out here in front of us. Scott, what do you think about this? I'm telling you, these are six of the biggest, toughest men in the business today. And you know all about superstar Steve Fender, I know.
I know just about everything about superstar Steve.
And right now, he's working on Heath Hatton, and we've got the man Axe and the Iron Man, Ken Casa, tied up, and then Big Troll and Sean Vincent, the Canadian hero, the ambassador for SICW. I know this thing started before the introductions were made, but the referee called for the bell. He's going to have to try to restore some order here. Superstar Steve Fender.
Oh,
what a big right one. These guys are no joke. I'm telling you, a big uppercut. Now, off of the apron, comes down, and superstar caught him and run him right back into the ring apron. The referee's trying to gain some support here, some law and order. I'm not sure if he's going to. Everybody's outside, nobody's inside.
It looks like Sean Vincent's trying to get a hand on a big troll over there.
That's 400 plus pounds, and he runs him right into that iron post. And now, superstar working on Casa. There's no legal man, Scott, I can tell you. This thing hasn't even, we've got Hatton laying down here on the floor in front of us. Travis Cook.
You know, there's one thing about it. The referees around here really need to get control of this kind of action. You know,
here's another guy, Travis Cook, never lost for words.
I'll drive him on the floor. He's dedicating this one to you, Herb Simmons.
Axe now. What's he doing?
Give it to him, Axe.
Oh, no, there's no mats on this floor. Oh, he picks him up. Here he goes for a pile driver. Oh, no.
He's trying to get him up there. Looks like he's going to reverse it. Yes.
And Scott, as you know, just like with New Breed Wrestling, there's no mats around that ring.
There's no mats. That's solid concrete right there, buddy.
And, oh, here we could have a pin. Superstar trying to get the shoulders of Sean Vincent down. Vincent off the rope. Oh, that big knee by Steve Fender. Outside the ring, Casa, Hatton. Whoa, back and forth. Look at this. They got him in between both of them, and it's just back and forth. There he goes, shoulder into that iron post. Uh-oh, here comes the big man. Big Troll being worked on by the Iron Man, Ken Casa. He's got him in a sleeper. That didn't take too long. That big elbow broke that one up. In the ring, I don't know. It looks like the legal men here are Sean Vincent and Steve Fender. Oh, catches him with that snap clothesline. A one count. Scott, this action so fast, it's hard to call it.
There's action all over this building tonight.
I think the referee is trying to pay attention to Sean Vincent and superstar Steve Fender. Oh, man, I felt that all the way down here.
Superstar knows how to lay them chops, and you're going to feel them when you get one coming to you.
Oh, I'm telling you. Well, I think after about 3 or 4 minutes, we're trying to get the order restored here. It looks like superstar Steve Fender and Axis continuing to double team the Canadian hero, Sean Vincent. The Iron Man, Ken Casa, here on the floor right in front of us. There, Big Daddy, Travis Cook on the opposite side of the ring. Wow. What action here in East Grundlett. SICW Wrestling Explosion fans, where you will see the finest in professional wrestling. Whoa, backwards. Sean Vincent finds himself still being worked on. A tag's made, and now.
Looks like Superstar's got that boot sitting on that top rope.
Well, and he's going to introduce
five
it into it.
Down. 5 minutes have elapsed. 15 remain.
5 minutes have elapsed into this match, and I think we've only had about 1 minute of where I knew who was doing what. Referee, Shaft.
Yeah, looks like the Superstar's having some words with Shaft, the ref up there.
Oh, Vincent stops it, and in. He introduces the head of Fender into that top turnbuckle.
Sean Vincent just delivered one of them chops of his own back to the Superstar there.
Oh. Boy, that will wake
nice
you up.
Nice reverse with a knee drop to the forehead there.
Oh, diving headbutt.
You know, Herb, I'm starting to notice a little bit about that Superstar Steve. It seems like he's using a lot of the legendary Harley Race moves in this ring.
I was just getting ready to say that. Nobody delivered that diving headbutt better than the greatest of all times, Harley Race. And you can see when Steve Fender gets in there and measures him up, you can tell he's out of that Harley Race camp, I can tell you. And he continues now to work on Sean Vincent in that corner. Referee telling him to let him out of the corner. Sean takes matters in his own hands, and now he goes up, and he's going to deliver some right hands. And this crowd.
Ooh.
That's not a good thing.
Yeah, that definitely knocked a couple teeth loose right there. Control wants to come in and just get a happy shot in there.
Tag's made, and it looks like the man Axe comes in, and they stay right on Sean Vincent. Sean really needs to get a tag made. Referee.
King Constance in there. Referee's kind of trying to keep control of the match.
Nice vertical suplex delivered by the man they call Axe. He wanted the three count, but referee Shaft said, nope, you only got a two on the man. Tag's made, and in comes 400-plus pounds. They call him the Troll.
That's a big man right there.
And I'll tell you, in the last, since he's came back to SICW, he's added a few other spectacular moves. He's delivering a drop kick now from the standing position, and that's hard to do. Shades of Crusher Blackwell used to do it.
Right.
And, talk about a power slam.
It looked like the ring moved on that move.
Man. And now what's he doing? Oh,
there's some type of submission here.
This is kind of a shade of the bone arrow that was used by John Paul Henning back in the 1960s. Only John Paul Henning would grab the man by his chin and pull back, but this could be a submission. This is a version of that bone arrow. But now he just gets on top of him and starts delivering those big right. And Troll trying to scare down the referee.
Shaq have none of that. He's going to stand up and run to keep law and order in this match.
And I got to bet, Scott, right about now, Sean Vincent is saying, where is my corner? Where are my teammates? They've done a great job of keeping him isolated here.
I believe Sean's been in there since the bell actually rung and had control of this.
Oh, look at this.
Oh.
Hatton comes in. He breaks that up.
Well, I think all that's going to do is make the superstar a little angry there.
I do, too. Benson trying to work his way back, punches to the midsection. But Bender says, I'll have none of that.
Oh, man. Big boot to the chest.
I got to tell you, fans, you're watching SICW Wrestling right here, and it is on fire tonight. Oh, both men had the same idea. And now Heath Hatton and the Iron Man trying to get Sean Vincent into it here.
Crowd's coming alive now. They want it. They want that tag. They want some fresh men in there.
Well, and there's nobody wants it more than Sean Vincent right about now, I bet. I'll tell you, he's trying to crawl his way over. Is he going to be able to make it? Slowly but surely. Both men.
Both men going for that tag. There's the tag.
Oh, here we go. What's going to happen? Heath Hatton and Axe. Whoa, big clothesline takes him down. A second one. Oh, reverse elbow. Oh, a beautiful drop kick.
10 minutes down. 10 minutes have elapsed. 10 remain.
Right there. Beautiful drop kick. Heath Hatton says, well, you want more? Here I come. And he charges in with that big ride, and he takes off Troll off the apron. He measures him up. There goes Axe. He comes in again. A fender from behind, and nobody.
This is going to change everything here.
Oh, you aren't kidding. Oh, shooting him in there like a torpedo. What a maneuver.
Had a crowd like that run up the back and hit the other guy in the back there.
And now he's got him by the hair of the chinny chin chin. Oh, wait a minute.
Trying to get him up. He's trying to get him up.
400 pounds. He's not going to do that easy, I can tell you.
Big forearm across the shoulders.
The Iron Man, former SICW champion, working on the big man, the Troll. And now they bring him out of the corner. What are they going to do? They're going to try to. It's going to take both of them to get him up. Whoa. Watch the ring.
Oh.
Up and down he came. But now look at Fender. He pulls out the Iron Man. Whoa. More action outside the ring. We've seen these two battle before. And right here in front of us, they're locked up again. In the ring. It's the Axe off of the ropes. Oh, a spine buster delivered by Heath Hatton. We got action in the ring, and we got action outside the ring. Fans, only at SICW will you see this on Wrestling Explosion. You heard
that? Looks like Sean Vincent's going up top here.
Oh, right here in front of us. What's
right
he going to do?
Front. Here
he's
comes.
Coming off. Oh! Right off
up
of the top.
All four down.
Cow. Oh!
What a remove.
We got bodies outside the ring. Heath Hatton just ran that shoulder into that iron post. Axe now. Looks like he's going to measure him up. This could be. He's going to do a pile driver in the ring. He's trying to get him up. Once again, is this going to be it? No. Heath Hatton takes him down. Whoa. No, he hooks him a nice backside. One, two, three.
There it is.
Heath Hatton victorious over the man they call Axe. Holy cow, Scott, what do you think about that one? Let's get the official announcement from our ring announcer, Dr. Drew Ebbenhaus.
At 12 minutes and 20 seconds, the winners of this matchup are your Canadian hero, Sean Vincent. You and the Iron Man, Ken Costa.
From the World Series champion Tigers in 45 to the Gateway Grizzlies to the 03 State Tournament Belleville East Lancers. A tradition in baseball and an even longer tradition in fine furniture and service. Miller Furniture, 1004 East Main in Belleville.
Let Custom Truck Upholstery give your vehicle a facelift. Visit us on 707 North 20th Street in East St. Louis, Illinois. Custom Truck Upholstery merges old-world craftsmanship and attention to detail with the latest in modern technology to make your car, truck, boat, or motorcycle look like new. Call Custom Truck Upholstery at 618-875-9850.
Ladies and gentlemen, mark your calendars. SICW returns to the East Carondelet Community Center Saturday night, July the 15th. Summertime is heating up and the action is getting hot. Reserve your seats at 618-286-4848. All of your favorite SICW stars will be in action July the 15th, Saturday night. Once again, get your tickets at 618-286-4848.
Pole, he quite often will use some wrestling moves. And at one time, the Big Texan was a person who got cheered here a lot, and he did some wrestling moves too. Side headlock there. Flying tackle that did nothing with Clint Pole. Clint Pole says, you got to be bigger than that, big man, at 320 pounds to knock me over at 280 pounds.
I remember when you used to make the call about years ago when you would talk about a collision on Lindell and Kings Highway when they would run into one another like that.
Well, now it happened on State Street Road right here in East Carondelet. And we've had a couple of collisions and nothing seems to be happening when they run right into each other. Well, ooh, big elbow smash and then a forearm smash.
Back and forth, they're going to start the brawl, and they back the Big Texan into the corner, but no, he returns it around. Referee trying to get him out of that corner.
He just was plugging away Big Texan, flailing away with that fist. A fierce attack. He pushes referee Nick Rowe. He pushes referee out of the way. Here goes Bo. He pushes the referee out of the way.
Needs to make. Wait a minute. Referee's calling for the bell. These two are going at it. I'll tell you. Big Country and Big Texan. And now they're going outside. Referee's called for the bell. He got shoved down by both of them, and he's going to have his hands full with this one, Larry.
We were right. It's not a scientific match. Poe and Big Texan pounding on each other. At one point, Poe had the best advantage, but now they're getting pushed backwards towards the dressing room door.
Well, we're going to go up, and I'm sure that's going to be a disqualification error.
The old season is over. The new season is coming. The Gateway Grizzlies are building for a spectacular campaign. The talent will be strong, hard-hitting, solid defense, reliable pitching. Plus, as always, the Grizzlies will have a schedule of superb promotions. It will be fun for the entire family at the right price. The Grizzlies were named the Frontier League Organization of the Year. The home for all this baseball excitement is a remarkable GCS ballpark. Make plans now to enjoy baseball the way it should be. For more information and updates, go to gatewaygrizzlies.com.
Unique and affordable gifts and collectibles on the internet are available at the Black Bear Haversack Trading Post. Go to blackbearhaversack.com. Semi-precious stones, bone horn and soapstone items, abalone shells, genuine coyote and water buffalo teeth pendants, products for Civil War, medieval and Renaissance reenactments, and so much more. For a 10% discount, mention SICW number 7 when you place your order. It's blackbearhaversack.com for top quality at reduced prices.
Andy Anderson, on March 17th of 1962, Johnny Valentine stepped into the squared circle to face off with Bill Frazier. And at this time, Johnny Valentine has a 9-year-old son named Greg with aspirations to follow in his father's footsteps.
There are 10 minutes left.
Bill Frazier with the headlock on Johnny Valentine. Ought to be some kind of a television show for Valentine, you know, like Johnny Dollar or something. Yours truly, Johnny Valentine. Well, I was a teenage pizza or something. Wake up, Roy. Bill Frazier and Johnny Valentine. John hasn't used that baking soda Arm & Hammer that he likes to use. Boy, he drives him right into the ground. The natives are counting the beads. Look like a Valentine fan. Joe Schoenberger's our referee, and he's bouncing around pretty good. I hope you can hear that one lady. Her voice seems to just pierce right on through. Oh, boy. Is that ever smart? Joe Schoenberger says break the hold. Hope he was smoking a Thinking Man cigarette because he was sure thinking. Valentine's in the corner, but he'll be out of it in a minute. Here we go, bargain basement. Here it comes. Whoop. Oh, boy. This is better than brushing between meals. Joe Schoenberger's the referee. One. Not enough. Here comes Valentine again. He's going to set him up. In front of us here, down among the looms. Johnny Valentine. Back down right in front of us here. He's coming up with the tweed pattern. Joe Schoenberger. Whoop! There it was. Here we go. He missed him. Got him on his shoulder. On the neck. And Valentine has got him. 2-3.
Ladies and gentlemen, mark your calendars. SICW returns to the East Carondelet Community Center Saturday night, July the 15th. Summertime is heating up and the action is getting hot. Reserve your seats at 618-286-4848. All of your favorite SICW stars will be in action July the 15th, Saturday night. Once again, get your tickets at 618-286-4848. Folks, let's jump ahead about two decades in time. The nine-year-old boy named Greg we mentioned has now turned into a full-grown man and comes to St. Louis as a splitting image of his father, Johnny. So let's take a look at this second-generation grappler against Gil Guerrero.
Guerrero, a standing leg split now by Greg Valentine on Gil Guerrero. And again, you can see that perfect balance that Valentine has so he can push into the leg, stretch out that hamstring some more. Valentine brings the knee into the other leg. Now Valentine steps over. He can very easily turn this into a half crab on Guerrero. Guerrero tells the referee no, he won't give up. Guerrero, a very awkward and painful position. Valentine sees the back right there for him. Shifts into a double toe hold. And make sure his knee stays in the small of Guerrero's back and puts punishment again, pressure on both legs. Valentine reaching inside that double toe hold, using his shoulder as a pressure point. And Guerrero painfully crawls underneath the ropes. Discretion before valor in this case. It hurts, and he got out of the way. Valentine, those stomps on the back. Greg Valentine using that second rope for extra leverage to go to the air and punish the back of Gil Guerrero. Valentine took those punches of Guerrero, battled back himself. That chop was on the money. Guerrero tosses Valentine to the ropes. Oh, Valentine comes off with that brain buster right to the head of Guerrero. Guerrero was setting him up for the backdrop. Valentine instead with the brain buster and then bangs the elbow into the chest, knocking the wind out of Guerrero. Valentine grabs the leg, both legs up, spins the toehold, locks it around, cinches it up, and there's that figure four leg lock. The figure four leg lock by Greg Valentine on Gil Guerrero. And Guerrero has no choice but to submit. Greg Valentine runs roughshod over Gil Guerrero. And it's about 50-50 cheers and boos for Greg Valentine. He just went in there and hard-nosed, tough customer that he is, polished down, methodically wore down Gil Guerrero. We're going to get another look at Valentine cinching up that figure four. One brain buster already landed. There's that elbow driven in again. Guerrero already stunned. Valentine following it up, grabs the legs, makes sure the man's in the middle of the ring. Good ring sense by Greg Valentine. Locks it up, makes sure he has it cinched good so he can really rip at that cartilage in the knee. And the figure four leg lock gives Greg Valentine the win. Here's Mickey Garagiola.
In 7 minutes and 9 seconds, with the figure four, the winner, Greg Valentine.
Wrestling fans, we appreciate you joining us for this special Father's Day episode of Wrestling Explosion. Sean Vincent, Heath Hatton, and Ken Casa victorious in six-man tag team action. The Big Texan and Big Country Clint Poe got their match thrown out as they turned their aggression towards the referee. It's hard to imagine we've seen the final battle between these two men. And how about father and son Valentine's Johnny and Greg wowing St. Louis audiences over several decades? Fans, it's more great wrestling action just like this each and every week on Charter Spectrum Cable and on the Fight TV app. I'm Drew Abenhouse. Thanks for joining us. We'll see you next time on SICW Wrestling Explosion.
One more time, ladies and gentlemen, your winners, Ken Costa, Sean Vincent,